हाउ टू सबमिट साइट मैप, हाउ टू सबमिट द वेबसाइट टू द सर्च इंजिन्स। देर इज वन बिग कंफ्यूजन अमंग लॉट ऑफ पीपल। आफ्टर यू हैव क्रिएटेड ए वेबसाइट, विल द साइट ऑटोमेटिकली गो इन टू द सर्च इंजिन्स? सो आई गेट मिक्सड आंसर्स फॉर इट, बट इज एक्चुअली रियल कंफ्यूजन। Will the search engine automatically pick a website? Maybe that today I start a site may not be immediately, may not be tomorrow, but could be after few days. Will my site automatically get indexed in Google, Yahoo, Bing, and all the major search engines? Or do I have to inform each of them separately? Say, this is my site, please put it into your database. So in case the site is present into the search engine, while I search with my website address, I should be able to find my site. Let's have a look. I go into Google and search for amazing information, accurate info 94.blogspot.com. While I do this, I do not find any website. Why is it asking questions? Okay, there is no result at all. That's the reason why all these questions are showing up. So though I've created this site long back, has been more than 10 days, but when I'm searching in Google, I'm not able to find my site. Even after 2-3 weeks you check it, even after 1-2 months you check it, you will not be able to find your site. And maybe a blogger belongs to Google. So this is a free site offered by Google. Even then you may not find it. Sometimes, maybe a private site, maybe WordPress, maybe Blogger may show up in the results. Like we initially had the address, I think 98 or 99. Okay, it's there here, 99. Later we change it to 94, that's why it's not showing up. So sorry, 99, right? Maybe after a few days your site may show up, may not show up, irrespective of the technology that is developed with. But I can prove that the site is not there in Google at all. So what I'm trying to say is that you may be able to find your website address in the results, but that will only come when a search is made with the website address. This happens in every search engine. Even though you may not have submitted the website, also it will show up here. The site may not be present in Google, still it will show up here. That is when, only when the entire website address is searched. But this site is actually not there in Google. None of the pages are there into the Google database. But how can we prove it? To check it, there's a different way. Never check like this with the site address. It will show up whether you have submitted or not. This is a way to check. So in any search engine, if you want to see how many pages of that site is present into that particular search engine, search with site colon site address. This is a professional way to check. Previously, we only search with website address where the query will get bypassed to the ICANN server. Now, ICANN server is the one which has got the list of all the website addresses, whether they are present into search engine or not. So whenever a search is made with site address, only then it will be fetched from that database. But you really want to know how many pages of this site is present into the search engine, site colon without any space, you need to mention the complete site address. How many results show up, that many pages of that site is present in that particular search engine. To justify my point, there's another thing that you can think of. If at all site and pages were automatically going to the search engine, then why do we find different number of results in Google, Yahoo, Bing, everywhere? Why should people use only Google? Why not Yahoo? Because whatever Google has got, even Yahoo has it. Because by default, the search engine will pick the website. Then what would be the difference between a search engine created by you and Google? I can become Google competitor in the day one. So the advantage Google has got is a database. If there are 100 sites in Google, not even 40 sites are there in Yahoo and Bing. That's the monopoly they enjoy. Fact of the matter, more than 50% of the websites are not there in Google. Forget Yahoo, Bing. There may be sites which are having all the features. Site may be very attractive, liked by the users, but they do not even know how to submit the site to the search engines. Whatever they say you do is all waste. First of all, the search engine should know that there is a page existing with so and so location. You can check other site, let's say birthday wishes. Results. So all these pages are from my website. Right from the first till the last. There will be only my site address pages. So how many pages of my site is present, that number will be shown here. Not even a single page must be missed out. I want to know how many pages of Facebook is there in Google. The same code you can type it in Yahoo. You'll get to know how many pages of your site is present in Yahoo search engine, Baidu search engine, Yandex search engine. Baidu is Chinese search engine. Yandex is Russia. More than Google, they use their local search engine. Forget more than Google, Google is banned in China. So this is a fact, in case you do not know, keep in mind that Google is banned in China. So there they are promoting their local search engine called as Baidu. You know how much of money they have saved for themselves? Today Google is 160 lakh crore. Valuation. If China is not using it, it means that 30% of the world's population is not using it. The main contributor of revenue is India. We all Indians are using this American website, and all the revenue is going to Americans. 50% of the users to the search engine is India. 50%. Facebook is banned in China. YouTube is banned in China. All these sites' valuation put together is more than double the GDP of India. Imagine if we also do the same thing what China has done. We block all this, we boycott it, and we promote our own local Swadeshi websites, replica. So China, how he has got Baidu like Google, how he has got Soku.com like YouTube, like that even for Facebook they have got a site. So they only believe in promoting their own local website. That simple thing, if you do it, if you implement it, because developing a search engine is no rocket science. But thing is, how do you get the visitors on board? That awareness has to come among the Indian public itself. IndiaSearch.com, like there are so many others. China, the government has banned it. It does not take more than a day for our government also to boycott these websites. Even if you open google.com in China, it gets redirected to Baidu. Such kind of setting can be done in a minute from Try department. Yet government doesn't do it. Isn't government aware how much of a gain our country would get in case we ban all these sites? They are well averse of it. They might have already got these kind of suggestions. Again, these are not small businesses. Yet they are keeping quiet. It may sound very easy to tell that why doesn't government ban all these sites and promote only Indian-based website and save a lot of revenue to get into the hands of foreigners. To say it's all very simple. But what will happen is the geopolitical tensions. We have big support from America. Do you think they are going to keep quiet? They are going to retaliate. They are going to put a ban on the jobs, H-1B visas. Then they may say that all the projects only in-house, we may not get outsourced projects to the IT companies. But even after all that, what we gain is much more than what we would lose. It's a bold step, of course. But then the biggest problem is the geopolitical tensions. Never make any powerful country your enemy. We do not have good relation with our neighboring countries. Because of the support of America, maybe they are also stable. They are not doing any kind of action against India. Like say, talk about China. They have been very aggressive in their approach. But because there's a pressure from the Western countries, it is quiet. So we require this kind of support every time. The problem is we cannot live on our own independently, at least from geopolitical perspective. India hasn't reached that stage. But the day we come there, then we need not be dependent upon any of the American websites. WhatsApp, ban it, create our own local app. Facebook, ban it, create our own social networking site. Search engine, ban, create our own. Like this, even the top 10 sites, if you have a replica local-based website, India can go tax-free, believe me. We need not pay tax at all. That much of revenue the government would get. Imagine 160 lakh crore, 120 lakh crore, these are the valuation of the websites. Facebook, 10 lakh crore. Government tax collection is 11, 12 lakh crore every year. Direct tax collection. Indirect tax collection, 12, 13 lakh crore. Here a single website valuation is 160 lakh crore. Billions of page views happen in India. And let me tell you, the day this decision is taken, American stock market will come under crisis. Companies' profits are going to go downhill. The entire revenue is going to circulate within India. India is going to gain immensely, there's no doubt about it. But the only risk here is the geopolitical relations. So maybe someday in our future we'll get to see that when India is confident to take its stance without depending upon any other country, then maybe this rule will come. Already they have banned a lot of products coming from China, but we are all focusing on the physical products. Even think about the virtual business. We got to have our own operating system. We got to have our own manufacturing brand of mobile, laptop, websites, IT, just virtual IT also, if they focus, then India can save a lot of revenue going into the hands of foreigners. So hope that day will come soon in our life. But right now, coming back to the point. So any website you want to check how many pages are there into any search engine, not just in Google, the formula remains same for any search engine. No space in between. Site colon site address. I want to see how many pages of Facebook. You can easily see. No one can stop that. ₹171 crore pages of Facebook are present in Google. Right from the first till the last, it will be only Facebook pages. Your and my profile is also there in this list. Maybe lying in some crores of pages. So any website, if you want to know how many pages are there in any particular search engine, this is a code. So quickly note down this point. All right, so hope you have noted this point. Now comes the question. If sites were not by default going into a search engine, how do we add our website? More importantly, how do we add all the pages of our site into every search engine? Now there are plenty of sites, third-party websites, wherein if you submit your site there on your behalf, they are going to submit it to every search engine, popular search engine. There are 50 to 70 popular search engines globally, where 80% dominance is of Google. So in Google, at least, we have to make sure that everything is done manually. For other search engines, you can make use of third-party tools. In Google, if you search, add site to all search engines, you'll find plenty of third-party sites here. Through all the sites you can do it. Or you can even search like this, submit site to all search engines. There's a site called as Free Web Submission. It has got a big list of search engines where it is going to submit. So you can go to this site and submit it. So it has even Google. So these are the 50 popular sites, another 20. This is more than sufficient. Google itself has got 80%, rest of them maybe 19% and 1% miscellaneous. So here I need to type my site address. So my new site address is AccurateInfo94. In case you have converted from free site to private, submit private site, not free site. You may be having HTTPS or HTTP. If you have opted for SSL certificate, secured protocol, then you'll be having S. You haven't opted, then it will be only HTTP, unsecured site. Or if you are confused, submit both the varieties. Give the name, email ID, select the terms, click on submit. May take few seconds. Most of the search engines it will be able to submit. Some will be failed, there you got to submit manually. While wherever it is not able to submit, where the bots are stopping him, is telling to click to complete, click to complete. That means through third party website you cannot submit to Google, you cannot submit to Bing, you got to submit there manually. And wherever it is failed, there also you got to submit manually. So he's saying to go to Bing Webmaster Tools. And here it is saying to go to Google Webmaster Tools. So now we need to understand what is this Webmaster Tools. Now point here again. Though we might have gone into Google and searched for submit site to all search engines, open any of this result, they are same like free web submission. You add your site and submit it. Though in majority of the search engine it will get submitted, but you need to understand only the home page has been submitted, not all the pages. This is not the professional way of submitting the site. There is a basic method or primary method, but you need to do even the second part of it, which is submitting sitemap. So firstly do this, add the home page, and then do the next part, which is through webmasters, wherein we have to submit the sitemap. Shortly we'll understand what is sitemap. I've told you more than 50% of the websites don't know how to add their site. In the remaining 50%, more than 50% do not know what is a professional way of submitting the website. So having just submitted the URL, you have already bet 75% of the competitors. Because Google is not aware of those pages at all. For any keyword, if you find 1 crore results, they are actually 4 crore results. But so many pages are not at all there, even the database of Google. So Yahoo, Bing, the number is even less. So just submitting the website will have little edge to our site compared to the competitors. Of course, those who are expert in SEO are already familiar with the method. So the first step towards SEO is actually submitting the website. On page you can do even later, but immediately after you have created the site with one page of content, let the site go into the search engine. Then you can do SEO. Maybe any page you are editing, lot of editing you have done, those things will get updated in the search engine automatically after a few days. Maybe you want to change the title tag, description, image alternative tag. All these changes you can do whenever you want, it will get automatically updated into the search engines. So do not delay in submitting the website, because today that we have submitted, it will not get indexed immediately, it takes time. And how those pages will get indexed, all that will be able to see in the Webmaster Tools. So let us first understand what is sitemap and then how to submit the sitemap, which is the professional method to add all the pages of your website into any search engine. To add the URL to the Google, you can go google.com/addurl, but then it again will not serve the purpose, because it will only take the home page. We want every page to go into the search engine. So maybe you can do this plus sitemap both. And then submit to all the major search engine directories by visiting the site like Submit Express. Like free web submission, there is another site called as Submit Express. The way to check your site is like this, which we have already seen. Now we'll understand what is sitemap. So just write down 2 lines about sitemap. It is an XML file. That has address of each page of your site. It can be even HTML, so XML or HTML. So sitemap is an XML file or it is an HTML file. Why only XML HTML? Why not .NET, Java, PHP, SQL? It is because XML and HTML is a common language for every search engine. If it was different technology, .NET may not be understood by Bing search engine. Java may not be understood by Google. So that's why they decided one language has to be common for everybody. So XML is the data representation language. So if you have created a sitemap in XML, the same sitemap file can be read by Google, Yahoo, Bing, Baidu, Yandex, every search engine. Have you ever wondered how come you are able to swipe one bank credit card or debit card into another bank's machine? I may be having an ICICI Bank debit card, but I go to SBI Bank, their ATM counter, and I swipe it, I'm able to withdraw it. But the technology of SBI, the software what they are using for banking operations is different, while that of ICICI Bank is different. But how are they able to communicate with each other? It is through XML, which happens through API, Application Programming Interface. So whatever their local database code is there, that all instructions will get passed through an XML program. So here ICICI Bank ATM card is going to pass the instructions. And then SBI machine, it is also going to pass the instructions through XML, like modulation, demodulation of internet. By that way, they are able to communicate. So likewise, even here in sitemap, always create the file in XML, which every search engine can understand. HTML will also do, but HTML has got some restriction. You can't have as many pages as possible. In XML, you can. So XML is considered to be data representation language. Keep this point in mind. So how does a sitemap look like? Let me show you one sitemap file for my own site. Birthday wishes. So go to my site address / sitemap.xml. Very simple program. Same pattern of code gets repeated. This is all in XML. So URL, then in bracket LOC, /LOC/ modified date, when the post was modified, what is the URL. This is what you need to mention, and the same thing gets repeated. For every page, you'll have the code repeated. So in this format, you need to create an XML file. You may not be familiar with XML. You can make use of these kind of sites. There are plenty of sites in Google if you search. Create XML sitemap. So many sites have come up. Anywhere you can create it, same file will get created. Here you need to mention the site address. Let's say I want to create a sitemap file for PackMoveFast. Do not have even a single broken link. In case you have got a broken link, sitemap file will not be able to create. It will scan through all your pages through internal links. Download. This is what is my sitemap file. You can open that and see. This is what is a sitemap file. So automatically the code has come and all the URLs have come associated with it. Alright. Now this file, I need to submit it in the Webmaster Tools, which I'll come back later. Right now only focus on creating sitemap file. So So in case you have got a general website, you can make use of these kind of websites to create the sitemap file. While for Blogger, you do not have to create sitemap file. It is automatically created while you have created the website. You can access the sitemap file at the location /rss.xml or /sitemap.xml. Both are one and the same. This is a sitemap file. It is using version 1.0. Chrome is not able to read it, but search engines will definitely read that. It is not properly resolved, but this is a proper format of XML file. This file will do for the search engine. They can resolve it. Or you check in the old browsers and all, it will show perfectly like this one. So you do not have to create any sitemap file for Blogger. For general site, you have to make use of third-party tools. Once a sitemap file is created for a general site, like example, pack move fast, we are able to see all the URLs. But this is in the local system that I'm checking. The file got downloaded in your system, there you have opened it up. But search engine won't come to your system to read this file. You will have to manually upload this file in the root folder of your website, in the server. Let me show you how. Wherever you have taken the hosting, you go there. Login and go into the file manager of the hosting account. Only in the control panel you'll find the file manager. Public HTML. This is where we have dumped all the files and folders of the website that we created. Click on upload and select that sitemap file which you have downloaded from a third party website. Then this file will be able to access online, which I've already done it here. See. This is a file we have done. This is created from third-party applications. You can even see packmofast.com/sitemap.xml. Now this file is online, created using the same website, which we have already uploaded it long back. I want to edit this sitemap file with a new page. See, right now what all pages are there, they have all gone into the sitemap. But tomorrow you publish a new page, you will have to update the sitemap file. And to update, select, click on edit. In case you have edited a URL, you have deleted a URL, or you may have come up with a new URL. So in all these three cases, you will have to update the sitemap file. So you know which section of the code is being repeated, copy that. Let's say packmovefast.com/Sikindrabad is a new page that I have created. At what time? I created in 2021. Whatever. So any new page that you want to add like this, you can do it in the server itself and click on save changes. Otherwise, delete this old file. Again, go to sitemap generator, put in your website address, a sitemap file will get created with all the URLs, with the new URLs too. Then you can directly upload that in the server. Replace the old file with the new one. Okay, hope this point is clear. So this is the way that you maintain a sitemap file for a general site. Sitemap is not going to get updated automatically for general site. You have to manually do the changes. However, in Blogger, the sitemap is uploaded and it gets updated also automatically. This is one small advantage in the Blogger as well as in the WordPress. The sitemap files are automatically created and updated in Blogger, and the location is site address /sitemap.xml. But important point, Sitemap is created, but it is not submitted. Submission part we have to do. We are only seeing the creation part right now. Firstly, sitemap should be ready. Then we'll see where to submit and how to submit. So for general site, do it manually. Login into server, upload it, edit it whenever there are changes in the URL. While for blogger, just observe it. Need not create, need not update. Both of them automatic. Now coming to WordPress. There are several plugins in WordPress by which you can create sitemap. By default, WordPress does not create sitemap file. But there are hundreds of plugins by which sitemap file will get created and also get updated in real time. So there are the most widely used plugin is Google XML sitemap. This is a plugin that you need to install and activate. Let's use it. So we install at rank metric. Plugins, add new plugin. So here I can search with a plugin. Google XML sitemaps. This is a plugin. Most widely used plugin is this. You'll find XML sitemap generator and all that. Don't go with any other plugin. Straight away install this one. This is the best plugin. Install. And then activate. That's it. Now when you go into the under settings, you get this option, XML sitemap. This option is coming here because we have installed the plugin. So your sitemap file is here. That means automatically the sitemap file got created at this location. This is the sitemap file. This is the front end of the sitemap file. If you do right click, view page source, you'll get the back end. Same format what we have seen. So this is the way the sitemap file has to be created in WordPress. Advantage in WordPress is same like Blogger. Once that we have created the sitemap file, the plugin will automatically update the sitemap file whenever you are publishing new pages, editing the page URLs, or deleting the pages. Sitemap files are not only to be created, but even updated in real time. In Blogger and WordPress, it is possible. General site, manually. Every change that you have done in the page, manually again update the sitemap file. So by this, you can save a lot of time. That's why people recommend Blogger and WordPress for SEO. A lot of things are automated here. So, one small point, major point. Alright. Now, once that the sitemap file is created, it is being updated in real time, the next step is submitting the sitemap file. In order to submit the sitemap file, you require an account in Webmaster Tools. Every major search engine will give you access to their Webmaster Tools. Now, what is Webmaster Tools? As the name itself suggests, a tool designed for the masters of the website, nothing but the SEO experts. There are so many things that you'll be finding in the Webmaster Tools. One is to submit sitemap, there's no alternative. You have to create an account in Webmaster, there only you can submit it. So in case we want traffic for every page of our site, it is mandatory to have a Webmaster's account. It's a free account. Along with this sitemap submission, there are a lot of things that you can see regarding the performance of your website in terms of SEO. So a tool designed by various search engines in order to monitor the performance of their site, in order to submit the sitemap, in order to have a communication regarding the drastic changes in the traffic, either risen or fallen through Webmasters, it is going to communicate to you. Only if you have Webmasters account, Google will send you notification if you find some sudden changes in the traffic in your site. Your site is marked as spam. Only if your account is into Webmasters, you'll get an email saying that from SEO perspective, we found that you have done some spam activity. What is done? How could you reverse? Everything will be explained in that mail. So it's a must-have account. There are so many things that you can see. We are going to discuss each of these points into the Webmaster Tools. Let us now, right now, see how to submit sitemap. In order to submit sitemap in Webmasters, you require to first add your site into the Webmaster Tools. So firstly, you'll be logging into Google Webmaster Tools. Then you'll add your site. Then you're going to verify your website, only post which the sitemap can be submitted. And once the sitemap is submitted, then you'll be able to monitor the performance of your website. So what are the steps? Login into Webmasters, add the website, verify the website, submit sitemap, then monitor the site performance. So let us see how do we add the site and verify in the Webmaster Tools. I'm showing you for Google, same way you can do it even for Yahoo and Bing. It's not required because 90% people in India use Google, 95%. But if you are targeting a keyword and expecting visitors to come from all around the world, then what we are doing into Google, same thing, you got to repeat it even in Yahoo Bing. Now Yahoo and Bing is one. So you can directly go to Bing Webmaster Tools. Even if you search for Yahoo Webmaster Tools, it will get redirected to Bing Webmaster Tools only. So let's do it. So the path to the Webmasters is google.com/webmasters. Click on Get Started. So once that you are logged in, straight away using your Gmail account itself, you can log in. And then click on Go to Search Console. All this we are going to discuss in the next class. Right now we are only focusing on sitemap. So firstly, these are all the sites which have been added and verified. Maybe in the first time when you log in, there will not be any site address here. So only post verifying the website, sitemap can be submitted. So I will click on add a property. So quickly this step, let me summarize. To submit sitemap, click on Search Console. Why it is written as add property? Why not add website? Because even if we have an Android application, that also you can add. So Webmaster Tools is used by the Android application guys as well as the website owners, both of them. So that's why it's written as add property, common to website and app. So what is a path? So H double T. In case you have got subdomains and all that, you have to make use of your site address here. Otherwise, directly here. Subdomain in the sense abc.xyz.com, likewise. So here, let's say I want to give my site address facebook.com. All my sites have been added, so just I'm giving a dummy website address here. Will tell you to verify. There are several ways to verify the website. This is a HTML file method. This is a HTML tag method. Any one you can use. This is a Google Analytics method. Tomorrow we'll be understanding Google Analytics. Google Tag Manager. One more method. And DNS method. Using any one of these five methods, you can verify the ownership of your website. Out of all, the simplest method is the meta tag. So select on HTML tag method, copy this meta tag. I've already told you, if it is a meta tag, it will go anywhere between the opening and closing head tag. So you know where this file, this code is present, in which file. If it is Blogger, edit HTML. If it is WordPress, theme, editor, header.php. See where I've added in WordPress site. Okay. Where to add? We'll see that. I'm logged in into the WordPress. I go to appearance, editor, the same place where we added the meta geo tag. header.php, this is where I can find the head section. Either you can place it right here, doesn't matter. The verification code, copy. Deleting the necessary column. Okay, so I copy the code and I place it right after the head tag or just before the closing head tag. Once that you have placed the code, you are going to click on update and then come back here, click on verify. You'll get a message that site has been successfully verified. But remember, verified but not submitted. Submission is next part. Before submission, this is mandatory. Which means that only the people who have got access to the admin panel or who are the owners of the website or where owners have given them the right, they can only add it. Today, I cannot add facebook.com in Webmasters because I don't have access to the HTML code at all. That will be there with Mark Zuckerberg. He has done it. So same website cannot be running parallelly into multiple Webmasters account. If your site you have added in Webmasters, I cannot add here. If I add here, then it will get deleted in your account. But I'll be able to only verify the website in case I have the access to the backend code. Admin credentials are required for it. That's why the name Webmasters, only the owners can add the website. Owners or authorized by owners. Till you give your credentials, admin credentials, no one can go into the back end of the website. So make sure that these kind of tasks you do not outsource but do it by yourself. Because you may want to maintain the secrecy of your site performance. So there is, in case you have technical skills and all that, you should not be giving your admin credentials to anybody. You can't trust anybody just like that. So these small things better manage by yourself. Someone, if you have given, you have outsourced your SEO project to some company, they'll tell that we would require your webmaster's account. So what we can say? Whatever is the code, mail me, I'm going to put it into the backend. Then they'll click on verify there. So they'll be mailing you this code, and that you can easily set into the backend. Tell them that the code has been set, you can click on verify. I won't be able to verify because this site is not mine, Facebook. In case the login ID of webmasters is same like blogger, then you will see that the sites have already been verified automatically. These all the sites, Blogspot you are seeing, I did not add them, but they have come here automatically because the login ID is same. That itself is a proof that the sites are mine. But for general site or where the login ID is different, you'll have to submit it with the method that I've shown you just now. So again, this is one small advantage with Blogger. Sites are automatically added and verified, but sitemap is not submitted. Now we'll submit sitemap. Once URL is verified, immediately it will get verified once the code is set. Then you will click on the verified website. Let's say there's a verified website, I click. Then on the left side, I click on sitemap. I've already submitted sitemap. Okay. Here you'll be giving the address. Okay, this is a old site. For old site, the sitemap URL was this one, rss.xml. So it is going to show error. But what is the path of the sitemap URL? That you can give it here. For general site, it is going to be directly /sitemap.xml. But in case you have put the sitemap file in a subfolder, then /folder name/sitemap.xml. So firstly, you open the sitemap file in the browser. What does the path look like? Like that only you got to submit it here. Let's see some new blogger if I have it. Here also it's already submitted. Anyway, you just give here sitemap.xml and then click on submit. You'll get a message as success. It will show you how many pages of the site have already been submitted, when it was submitted. So eventually this number will be equivalent to the number of pages in your website. It doesn't come immediately. You'll get a message as success, but this number will gradually increase. Day by day, some of the pages of your website will keep on going into the search engine, and a day will come where this number will be equivalent to the number of pages in your site. At that stage, we can say that all your pages have been submitted successfully in Google. Same thing in Yahoo, Bing, you got to do it. Now this sitemap file will get submitted automatically for Blogger and WordPress. Understand the difference. First is we have to update the sitemap file in case there is any change in the URL. Then we will have to come here and then resubmit the sitemap file. Because what is there today, that is all gone. Tomorrow, if the new pages are added in the sitemap file, you got to resubmit it here. So for general site, this is again a cumbersome work. But for Blogger and WordPress, it is a live connection. You do not have to submit the sitemap file again and again, only once. Once that you have submitted the sitemap file, automatically the new pages, the deleted pages, updated pages will get reflected here. This number will be dynamic. These are some of the advantages of Blogger and WordPress. live connection directly with the webmasters. This is the way to submit the site to the search engine. And like this, I told you, not even 20% of the websites have done it so far. That will give you an edge. Even though you haven't done SEO, just submit the sitemap, you will get traffic. For some keywords lying in the corner of your page, known as got marks, even with 1, 2, 3 marks in SEO, you'll be performing on the top. Very low competitive keyword. Let the search engines know that you have those pages. Only for sitemap submission, there is an immense charge in SEO. If you go into Google and search, sitemap submission service cost. Because people know that sitemaps are important, but they have no knowledge about it. Is providing an application to create sitemap file, $180. They are all application, but if you look at into SEO service, only for sitemap creation and submission, they'll charge you $4,000-$5,000 for 500 pages, 1,000 pages, like that. They have various packages, but not only creation, they even maintain it for 1, 2, 3 months. Based on that, they would charge. So SEO is an easy thing, but knowledge is not easily available. That's the reason why it is expensive. Okay, so that is all for today. Today we have discussed how to submit the website, the real process. Tomorrow we are going to discuss more about webmasters, what other things it has got to offer us. And then along with webmasters, we are going to discuss one more tool called as Google Analytics. Once we are done with these two tools, then we are going to begin with the off-page optimization. So today itself, at least if one page is ready in your site, please submit the sitemap. Add your site into the search engine. The time has come so that while we begin with the off-page and you do it parallelly, your keyword selection is good, then maybe before the course is over, you can see for some keywords your pages ranking in the top 10. That's why do not delay, do the task parallelly. Over to you for any kind of doubts.